to the barn in Rockland. We're gathered here to share in the service of morning prayer together. Today is the Sunday before Lent, and let me share with you a few notices for the days ahead. This evening we have our 4 till 6 prayer for care vigil, when I invite you to join for as much or as little of that time as you're able as we gather in prayer for those who care and those who they care for in this time of pandemic. Lent begins this week. On Shrove Tuesday, we invite you to our kitchen virtually. If you would like to share your kitchen, your pancakes with us, there will be a Zoom party from 5 till 7. Perhaps you'd like to tell us about the fillings that you enjoy, or if you're brave enough, you might even like to make a pancake for us on screen. We can share some fun together. So please let us know if you'd like a Zoom link for that. Into Ash Wednesday, 7:30 in the evening, we'll gather again, once again, via Zoom, here from the barn, for our service to mark the beginning of Lent. And then on Thursday, and each of the Thursdays in the next 5 weeks, we join across the group with the Thurt and Benefice as well for our Lent study evenings, beginning at 7:30. The theme this week is desert and baptism, as we think about the beginning of Christ's time in the wilderness. You're very welcome to join. Zoom links will be going out with this service, but if you would like to be sent that additionally, or would like to talk about how to observe this season of Lent, do please make contact and we will support you as best we can. Today is also Valentine's Day, a day that we think about love, we think about the people that we love, and we think, perhaps especially as we gather in worship, about our love in fellowship with one another, and most of all, God's love for us. And so we're surrounded by candles and lights in contrast to the season that we're entering, a solemn season of Lent. Today we feel very much the love, and we see the light, and we're really pleased to be sharing those things with you. And so we begin our worship. O Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Sentence of scripture from Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them the light has shined. And so we pray. The night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
And so we come now to seek God's forgiveness. We remember in a moment's quiet those things which we've said or done for which we wish to ask God's forgiveness. Your unfailing kindness, O Lord, is in the heavens, and your faithfulness reaches to the clouds. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Your righteousness is like the strong mountains, and your justice as the great deep. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
For with you is the well of life, and in your light shall we see light. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. So we receive God's forgiveness. May Almighty God, who sent his Son into the world to save sinners, give you his pardon and peace, now and forever.
Amen.
Today's psalm is Psalm 150. Alleluia. O praise God in his holiness. Praise him in the firmament of his power.
Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness.
Praise him with the blast of the trumpet. Praise him upon the harp and lyre.
Praise him with timbrel and dances. Praise him upon the strings and pipe.
Praise him with ringing cymbals. Praise him upon the clashing cymbals.
Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever.
Amen. Our first reading comes from the book of Exodus, chapter 24, beginning at verse 12. The Lord said to Moses, "Come up to me on the mountain, and wait there, and I will give you the tablets of stone with the law and the commandment, which I have written for the people's instruction." So Moses set out with his assistant Joshua, and Moses went up into the mountain of God. To the elders he said, "Wait here for us until we come to you again, for Aaron and Hur are with you. Whoever has a dispute may go to them." Then Moses went up on the mountain, and the cloud covered the mountain. The glory of the Lord settled on Mount Sinai, and the cloud covered it for 6 days. On the seventh day, he called to Moses out of the cloud. Now the appearance of the glory of the Lord was like a devouring fire on top of the mountain, in the sight of the people of Israel. Moses entered the cloud and went up to the mountain. Moses was on the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. For the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
second reading comes from the Gospel according to St Mark, chapter 9, verses 2 to 10. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And Jesus was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He didn't know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice, "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen, until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what the rising from the dead could mean. For the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Jesus took his closest disciples with him to the top of a mountain, and he was transfigured before them. Transfigure isn't a word that we use very often, but transfigure means to have our faces changed, literally. Jesus wasn't transformed, he wasn't changed into something else, but for a brief time, his closest friends saw him for who he is, the Son of God. And they see him here on this high point, on top of a mountain, which of course was the closest that earth came to heaven. And not just Jesus, but also Moses and Elijah. Moses, of course, was the one who had led the Israelites out of slavery into the wilderness on their journey to the Promised Land. And Elijah was the one who returned Israel to the worship of God. They were the great figures of the Old Testament, the Hebrew Bible. And those figures had both had very strong supernatural experiences connected with them. In our first reading, we heard of Moses meeting God on the mountaintop to receive the law, enveloped in clouds and in flame. And of course, Elijah, when he was in contest with the prophets of Baal, called on God to send fire from heaven to light the sacrifice that he was offering to prove that there was only one true God. And now comes this new supernatural occurrence. Jesus appears to change. He becomes dazzlingly bright in front of his followers. There can be no mistake now on who he is. And then everyone hears this voice, a voice from a cloud up in heaven. "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." Listen to him. When Jesus was baptized, the voice from the cloud had said, "You are my son, the beloved, and with you I am well pleased." That voice was addressed to Jesus. Now the voice from heaven, the voice of God, is addressed to his followers. Because from here, they are about to make a downward journey. After this incredible experience, full of awe and fear and wonder, they had to come back down to earth. And Jesus has to begin his journey to Jerusalem, his journey to the Passion, to the cross, to the tomb, in order to reach the destination of Easter and the joy of the resurrection. And Jesus' friends are given this vision to sustain them through all that lies ahead. But they will come back down to earth with a bump. And in the middle of this week, we also come down to earth, because Ash Wednesday is the beginning of Lent. It is the day when traditionally Christians put ash on their foreheads as a sign of our mortality, remembering that we are dust, and to dust we shall return. But Jesus shows us the splendour that is to be found in the dust, and the glory that we can find in him, and the hope that beyond the road of suffering and rejection and pain is the glory that will be revealed, the glory that Jesus achieves and wishes to share with us. And so let us take one last look at Jesus in his glory on the mountaintop, a glory we will see again, but only after the hard road of Lent has been traversed. Thanks be to God.
Jesus takes Peter and James and John up the mountain to pray. They want to immortalise that moment, and later we find them terrified. We will encounter them again at the end of Lent in the Garden of Gethsemane, as once again they try to watch and wait and misunderstand. Jesus simply wants them to remain in prayer with him on that night. And so we join with this company and with one another in prayer this morning. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. In these prayers, to the words, Lord, look with favour, I invite you to make the response, Lord, transfigure and heal. Lord of glory, it is good to be here. In peace we make our prayer to you. In trust, we confirm our faith in you. Help us to set our faces steadfastly to where you would have us go. As we anticipate this season of Lent, may you call us to holy observance and discipline. Lord, look with favour.
Lord, transfigure and heal.
Lord of glory, look with favour on your church, proclaiming your beloved Son to the world, and listening to the promptings of his Spirit. We pray for the Church as it ministers to communities in such diverse ways. May people see your glory from our lives. May we help them encounter you within their living. May your Church be renewed in holiness, that she may reflect your glory. Lord, look with favour.
Lord, transfigure and heal.
Lord of glory, look with favour on the nations of the world, scarred by hatred, strife, war and pandemic. May all people be healed by the touch of your hand. Look, Lord, with favour. Lord, transfigure and heal. Lord of glory, look with favour on those in need and distress, suffering as your Son has suffered, and waiting for the salvation you promise. We hold in a moment's quiet all those known to us who are in any kind of need, sickness, fear, or pain this day. May the day break and Christ the morning star bring them the light of his presence. Lord, look with favour.
Lord, transfigure and heal.
Lord of glory, it is good if we can suffer with you, so that we shall be glorified with you. According to your promise, bring all people to see you with your own eyes, their own eyes in majesty. May those who have departed be changed into your likeness from glory to glory. To you be praise, dominion and worship, now and for all eternity.
Amen.
And the collect for today. Almighty Father, whose Son was revealed in majesty before he suffered death upon the cross, give us grace to perceive his glory, that we may be strengthened to suffer with him, and be changed into his likeness from glory to glory, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
And so I invite you to pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Of our worship today. We pray that you may have a good, safe and blessed week as we prepare to begin our Lent journey. Christ, whose glory fills the skies, fill you with radiance and scatter the darkness from before your path. Amen. Christ, the Son of Righteousness, gladden your eyes and warm your heart. Amen. Christ, the day spring from on high, draw near to guide your feet into the way of peace. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and upon those you love, this day and forevermore. Amen.
Alone. Here in the power of Christ.